To the perils of self-betterment. Or not. Season 8 of Game of Thrones was the most disappointing ending to a TV show I've ever seen, and I know for a fact that this is the case for many of you. Game of Thrones was supposed to be the TV show of our generation, or rather, it is the TV show of our generation. It's probably the most popular show ever made. Everybody has heard of Game of Thrones, and a lot of us have seen it. And there's really, really good reason for it, because for very, very, very long periods of time, this show has many moments of brilliance. But season 8 was different. A lot of people started smelling it at season 7 and kind of lost hope for season 8. I was not one of those people. I had very, very high expectations for season 8, and I wanted the show to peak in quality at its ending, because the ending of any show is paramount. And this is the show, this is the one, the big one. So its ending has to be brilliant. And not only was it not brilliant, it was actually a bunch of nonsense. And here's why. Let's talk about what Game of Thrones has always been. Game of Thrones has always been a great show, at least for the first 4 seasons. I would say season 5 and season 6, at least for me, were pretty good as well. Season 7, you can ask some questions there. But the reason Game of Thrones was great was because of its ability to create suspension of disbelief. The quality of the writing was always so good that you could always believe in what was actually happening in front of you, regardless of how extreme it was, because it always felt real. It never felt strange or out of place or like a glitch in the Matrix. And the problem with season 8 is that it feels like one massive glitch in the Matrix. It doesn't feel real, and you can't really buy into it. The key to creating a great show, well, I suppose there are many keys, and I'm not going to claim to be an expert on this, but you have to have a world that you can actually buy into, meaning that the show has to be consistent with the rules of its own universe. That is what you need in order to be able to believe what you're actually seeing. And simultaneously, you have to have characters that make sense and that have motivations and choices that make sense for who they are. These things are two aspects that Game of Thrones has always nailed. And that's why it was always so shocking when really, really bad things happened to our characters. Because it felt like, wow, this is actually happening, I can't believe it, but I can. And that's the point. We all remember The Red Wedding. And the quality of the writing of season 8 feels like it belongs to a show that you're not going to remember a week after watching it, which is a massive, massive letdown for a lot of people. Normally, I don't make videos like this, but I was meditating this morning and my mind was racing about Game of Thrones, and when that happens to a subject, it's usually good for me to vent about it, so here we go. I think it's time that I talk about some of the specifics of the issue here. By the time this recording is happening, the final episode, meaning episode 6, has not actually aired yet. And that is a very tragic thing, because the truth of the matter is that it doesn't matter what happens in the final episode. At least not to me it does, because I don't care anymore. I don't care about any of this. I'm no longer invested in Game of Thrones, and I never thought I would say that. It's an absolute tragedy that it has come to this. But honestly, nothing can salvage any of what has happened at this point. I will admit, there are great things about the 8th season. I think the acting is ridiculously great. I'm not sure I've ever seen better acting in a TV show. Nor have I ever seen as high a production value. The cinematography is fantastic. The music is beautiful. Basically everything about the objective production of it seems like it is screaming that we are firing on all cylinders of quality. But, of course, we aren't. We're firing on all cylinders except for the writing, I guess, or whoever's making the decisions here. It's, let's just say, not working particularly well. Let's talk about the world and the rationale behind what's actually happening on screen. A lot of what happens in Season 8 is very, very difficult to justify from a rational point of view. Let's take probably one of the biggest sinners of all, the goddamn dragons. What were they thinking when they wrote these episodes? For one, let's just start with the Dragonfire. A single, undead Night King dragon cannot kill Jon Snow because Jon Snow has to have plot armor that's thicker than the mountain's dick. But as soon as Daenerys goes to King's Landing and wants to destroy an entire city, including all of its buildings, the Dragonfire works just fine. How about the ballistas killing the dragons? One episode, a dragon dies to 3 consecutive ballista bolts from Euron Greyjoy's fleet. And the next episode, Daenerys seemingly has no problems destroying, what was that, 200 or 300 ballistas by herself? It's just ridiculous. You honestly cannot justify this shit. And it's not just with the dragons. That was just one example. When you create a world, the laws of physics and everything that's happening in it has to be consistent with itself. And that's why Game of Thrones has always worked. It always felt like it was realistic, whatever was happening. It's not a question of realistic in terms of whether or not something is like our world. It's whether it's consistent with its own world. And what's happening with these goddamn dragons in Season 8 is just fucking ridiculous. Nobody's buying it. Nobody is buying it. You cannot buy it. You cannot make yourself buy it. The only thing you can do is try your best to gloss over it, not notice it, or just forget about it. And that is not the way you want to write a show of this magnitude. Enough with the world. Let's talk about the characters. Oh, where to begin? The goddamn characters. How about Jon Snow, who now has no balls? He has less ballsack than Varys. So many character things don't make any sense anymore. The only thing Jon Snow can say at this point is, "You are my queen." What happened to Varys and Tyrion? These guys were supposed to be the 2 smartest people in all of Westeros, and now they're both drooling morons? What the hell is happening here? Daenerys goes from glad queen to sad queen to mad queen in the span of 3 episodes. Am I supposed to believe in this crap? She's been the breaker of chains for 7 fucking seasons. And now she just turns for no reason at all? Look, I know that it was foreshadowed a bunch of times that maybe this could potentially happen, but we need to understand that foreshadowing and character development are not the same thing. Foreshadowing is not character development, let's get that right. And Daenerys was not in a position to where it made any sense that she would be burning civilians in King's Landing. It's so dumb, I cannot describe in words how stupid it is. Speaking of actual character development, why is Jaime back in King's Landing dying with Cersei? I thought the entire point of Jaime's story was redemption. This is the man who went from pushing Bran out of a tower window to going into a goddamn bear pit for the sake of Brienne of fucking Tarth. He spent 2 seasons traveling with Brienne, and you're just gonna throw all of that down the drain? He even left Cersei for the sake of fighting for humanity against the dead, and now he's just like, meh, fuck it, I'm gonna go back to, what, some stuck-up bitch who's oddly similar to Daenerys at this point? I just don't get it. I don't get Jaime, and I don't get Jon. None of it makes sense, and that's the problem. The one fundamental problem that is frustrating everybody about Season 8 is nothing makes sense. Nothing makes sense. It almost feels like the entire season was written with 2 points in mind only. Number 1, we need to wrap this up as fast as possible, and number 2, we need to try and shock people somehow while doing it. And it's not really that shocking, because no matter how extreme of a thing it is that we're watching, it doesn't actually matter if we can't believe in it. And that's the issue here, is we are watching material that feels non-canon. We are watching episodes that feel like shitty fan fiction. It feels like these episodes were written by an outsider, by somebody who has never seen Game of Thrones, or who has no passion for it, or who just fundamentally doesn't understand what Game of Thrones is about. And that's the issue. It's like they took somebody who's never been connected to the show in any way, sat them down at a dinner table and gave them a 3-hour debriefing on what the show is, and then told them, hey, can you wrap this up as fast as possible? Thank you very much. And then they looked at that and they said, wow, that's pretty good writing for a 12-year-old. Let's throw that in the garbage and make an actual show. Except they never threw it in the garbage. They took it to the big screen instead. Well, I guess not the big screen. The big screen would be the cinema. But regardless, the point is the same. The beauty of the shock and the twists and turns that made Game of Thrones so great was that it all made sense. It made perfect sense within the world. You just didn't expect it because you didn't see it coming, and because fiction can be a certain way. Oftentimes, fiction likes to protect its characters just because they are main characters. And it was Game of Thrones, of all shows, that has the balls to go against that. And now it's falling prey to that exact same issue. How many people survive in Winterfell against the undead when they shouldn't have? Samwell fucking Tarly, the man who has no fighting skills whatsoever, even has a little moment where he gets to cry his eyes out like the wimp he is when 1,000 Unsullied is dying around him. It's nonsense. It's absolute nonsense. You could mention so many specifics about why this doesn't work, but the point remains the same. There's nothing I can say that is going to justify the rationale behind the decision-making in this season. Nothing makes sense. The characters don't make sense. The physics of the world doesn't make sense anymore. Apparently that doesn't apply. Rationality is no longer a thing. Euron Greyjoy's fleet goes from Hawkeye to Stormtrooper in one fucking episode. It's just bad. That's the bottom line. People aren't disappointed because certain characters are dying or killing or whatever. It's not about who dies or who kills who. I mean, it used to be because, you know, that was the luxury that we were in at the time. But honestly, the problem isn't who's dying or who's killing. The problem is how it's done. And it's done so poorly. And it's so rushed. You can't help but feel like even 10 episodes to do this wouldn't have been enough. We should have had 2 seasons to finish this. Not 1 season, let alone 6 damn episodes. It's just not enough. And the writing is terrible because of it. At least that's what it feels like when you're watching it. It feels so bad. It feels so rushed. And it feels like you are just watching nonsense that you want to forget immediately. And that's what I hope people do. I hope that people forget Season 8, and I hope that they remember Game of Thrones for the amazing moments that it had. And honestly, my heart goes out to all the people who worked their asses off for Season 8, because clearly it has aspects of brilliance in it. And my god, the amount of work that has to have been put into this is just mind-blowing. And yet, this is what we have? It's a fucking travesty. It's an offense to the actors and actresses. It's an offense to the people who has worked on this. The decision-making is so bad, it pisses people off. That's what it does. Nothing makes sense, and that pisses people off. Game of Thrones Season 8 is disappointing garbage.